Welcome to Commonwealth Ballet's production of The Nutcracker on Masque. I'm Chip Morris, the Artistic Director of Commonwealth Ballet. For 23 years, we have been producing The Nutcracker for live audiences in the Metro West area of Boston. This year, of course, that isn't possible. Given that we must practice physical distancing, which is not easy for dancers, and also wear masks in public, we decided to embrace the mask and produce a film of the Nutcracker in which all of the performers wear beautiful theatrical masks. Moreover, because dancers cannot rehearse in groups, we filmed each dancer individually, and many of their younger dancers were rehearsed remotely from their homes. The result of the magic of film editing is a new version of the Nutcracker, which we present to you as a collaborative work of the young dancers of Commonwealth Ballet. We hope you enjoy our production, and we invite you to help us with a small donation. Just click on the donate button above. All of us at Commonwealth Ballet wish you a healthy and happy new year.
It was Christmas Eve, and Herr Drosselmeyer, an eccentric inventor, was putting the final touches on his spectacular mechanical dolls. He was preparing for the evening's festivities, a masked ball at the home of the Silberhaus family. Herr Drosselmeyer's nephew, Peter, stopped by on his way to the party. Later in the evening, children spilled into the Silberhaus parlor, each wearing an artful mask. The tree, full and fragrant, rose grandly before them. Sweets hung from its branches. Candles lit its boughs. Clara, her little brother Fritz, and the children were so excited.
Thank you.
presently, Peter joined the party and immediately caught Clara's eye. Together, they danced a joyful march. They even included the governess in the dance, only to be interrupted by the maid, who had drunk a little too much punch. Joined in the fun, soon followed by Herr Drosselmeyer, who was also Clara's godfather. This year, Herr Drosselmeyer arrived bearing two tall boxes. each wrapped in festive paper and tied with bright ribbon. Harlequin and Columbine popped out of the boxes. No bigger than a doll. The soldier's hair was snow white. His head was large and his features coarse. The soldier was a nutcracker. Herr Drosselmeyer presented the nutcracker to Clara, but jealous Fritz seized it from her. In the tussle, Fritz fell to the floor and, crack, something broke. Drosselmeyer shook out his handkerchief and wrapped the poor nutcracker's jaw, repairing the damage as best he could. That night, after the party, when the others had long since retired to bed, Clara crept back to the parlor and cradled the wounded nutcracker in her arms. she imagined how wonderful it would be if her new friend could grow and grow to become real. As Clara fell asleep, mysterious rustling noises filled the parlor. Clara awoke, groggy with sleep, and what? The room was filled with giant mice. Clara cowered in fear. As the clock struck midnight, Herr Drosselmeyer himself emerged from the clock to defend her. Were joined by their leader, the fearsome Mouse King. He was a leering, frightful creature. Saved her from the Mouse King's shiny sword. With his magic, Herr Drosselmeyer made the Christmas tree grow and grow and grow. Then, with a flash of his cape, he transformed the tiny nutcracker into a giant soldier as large as Clara. Fritz's toy soldiers, spirited and tall, marched out in tight formation to join the battle.
Thank you.
Clara was frightened, but she knew it was up to her to help her beloved Nutcracker. She knocked out the Mouse King by bopping him on the top of his head with a piece of cheese, and the toy soldiers were the victors. But the Nutcracker seemed mortally wounded. House parlor dissolved into a snowy blizzard. Out of the falling snow, a beautiful Snow Queen emerged with her entourage of reindeer. She transformed the Nutcracker from an awkward wooden figure into a handsome young prince. The prince led Clara to the edge of the ice-bright night as snowflakes fell as softly as blossoms.
Thank you.
Nutcracker Prince had led Clara to Herr Drosselmeyer's Castle of Dolls. Clara and the prince were met by the Sugar Plum Fairy and her subjects, amazing dolls from all over the world. Each would dance for Clara in the castle's ballroom. Spanish fandango dancers with flashing fans. Flowing silks that shimmered as she swayed. The Chinese doll entertained next, her pointed fingers representing chopsticks. high-stepping Russian kicked up her heels in a dance called a trepak. Jeweled Merlitons played their flutes for Clara. Neapolitan girl rattled her tambourine in a spirited dance. Then came spring flowers, ablaze with color and touched by a drop of dew.
Thank you.
Lastly, the Nutcracker Prince himself performed a powerful dance, followed by the Sugar Plum Fairy in an elegant variation, a fitting finale to the evening.
Thank you.
As the music faded, Clara knew it was time to return home, but she did not want to leave her friend, the Nutcracker Prince. "I'll never be far away," the prince reassured her. He promised Clara that they would see each other again one day. On Christmas morning, Clara awoke snug and warm. She recalled the adventures of the night before, the battle with the Mouse King, and the journey to Herr Drosselmeyer's Castle of Dolls. Through it all, she'd had the company of the prince. Clara hugged the Nutcracker to her. She wanted no other present. For Clara now knew the secret of Christmas. That magic is the best present of all.